Ooh, welcome everyone to the Daily Juice Podcast on the Betting Pros Network. I'm your host, Sean, stacking the money green. And as always, the Daily Juice is being brought to you by BetMGM. Use the promo code JUICE150 and you get a $1,000 risk-free bet. The juice is loose. Oh man, the days like these, this is why you become a gambler. I mean, yeah, did I go 2-1? Orioles game got rained out, so obviously that would have won. I mean, Orioles is a home dog. As we know, that's straight cash. Home
dog.
Orioles, yes, please. 1.5 on the run line. That got rained out. Now, would that have been a win? Probably. But hey, we didn't need it. Still went 2-1, up 0.9 units. But really, it wasn't the 0.9 units. It was just the dramatic fashion in which we won the 0.9 units. All right, let's get the loss out of the way. Giants, I was, you know, playing with fire there a little bit. I kept thinking maybe this Padres team is in a funk and they're just completely out of it. And, you know, it turns off that walk-off home run was just basically the spark they needed to completely wake their bats up. Although the Giants did get out to a 4-0 lead, ended up losing 13-7. So shout out to anyone who had the over. That was easy money for you. Again, when Giants were up 4-0, I was just driving around, listening to the game on the radio. Like, oh, Sean, you genius. You did it again. And then the whole thing unraveled. So Giants was a loss. Phillies. Like I said, I went to the Dodgers game. We'll get to that in a second. But my wife, who's a big Dodgers fan, we're driving to Dodger Stadium to watch the game. I got the Phillies on the radio. I'm like, oh, man, again, playing with fire. This Phillies team, they're hot. They were due, you know, Marlins pitcher was really good. And, they're not going to do it. They're not going to do it. And then bottom of the eighth, down 3-1, just gutsy. They had like a swinging bunt that, you know, rolled and stayed fair. It was just awesome. And winning bets, listening on the radio, and then going to Dodgers Stadium and winning a bet live in person, that Dodgers game was wild too. Dodgers got out up to a 2-0 lead. Then the Twins came back. The Twins were up 4-2. Then the Dodgers were up 5-4, bottom of the seventh. And then I was seriously worried because obviously I had -1.5, +115, so nice
dog
there. And I was just like, oh no, they're going to win the game now 5-4. They're not going to cover the 1.5. I'm going to have to pretend with my wife that I'm super happy. The Dodgers won. Oh, it's great. They were down 4-2. They came back. That's so fun. Oh yeah. No, I don't care if they lost -1.5. We didn't lose any money on that. I didn't want to have to do that song and dance. I'm not a great actor. That's why I'm doing a handicapping video 7 days a week. So Joey Gallo comes up, and then I'm talking to my wife, and she's had the same experience I had. Any Yankees fan in our lives goes, oh, Joey Gallo, thank God we got rid of him. So for some reason, they pinch hit Joey Gallo. And then I said to her, I swear to God, right before I go, he strikes out a lot, but he does hit some home runs. So maybe I can get this cover anyway. Boom. 3-run shot, 8-4. And then the icing on the D-gen cake, of course, after they go up 8-4, everyone leaves because it's Dodger Stadium. Me being the savvy baseball fan for the Dodgers, I know the way to beat traffic in a Dodgers game is to wait till the end of the game. So I'm going to wait till the end of the game. And then it's 8-4, top of the ninth. And in the back of my head, that little D-gen voice goes, you know, you got 2 runs here to play with. It'd be nice if you get a little sweat. They almost blow it. I think there were 2 on. The Twins got 1 there. It was 8-5, so they got the win. They got the cover. It was just an exciting day of gambling on baseball. Oh man, can't wait. And we got preseason football, little MLB action. Before we get to the picks, shout out to Run Your Pool. We are teaming up with them. We're running a free NFL Survivor Contest. Again, Survivor Contest, pretty easy. You just keep picking a winner. You can't use the same team twice. And whoever, the last survivor, essentially, you win first place. $150 gift card from Fanatics. $100 gift card to second. $50 gift card to third. Very easy to get set up over there. Just go to play.runyourpool.com/juice And there's also a similar pool being run with the Betting Pros podcast, play.runyourpool.com/bettingpros. So enter that one as well. I think that one's just a ATS pick'em, so that should be a lot of fun as well. I'll put the link in the episode description, and of course, bettingpros.com/chat. Get that in the Discord. If that wasn't enough, man, this company's awesome. Free podcast, free picks, and free autographed Brian Dawkins jersey. What? I don't know how this business model works. They just keep giving away stuff for free. YouTube.com/bettingpros. Subscribe there. Comment on this video that hopefully you're watching, because if you did comment on this and you're subscribed, you got a chance to win the autographed Brian Dawkins jersey courtesy of Pristine Auction. That thing looks just straight fire. And I'd be ready to run through a brick wall if I had that autographed Brian Dawkins jersey. So again, enter. Very easy. Turn those notifications on in YouTube. So when you win and we try and contact you, you get the notification. You don't want to miss out. You don't want to. I mean, come on. That would be worst case scenario. All right. Two NFL preseason picks, and then going back to the well for some MLB. Limited slate for MLB. Very interesting betting day today, or tomorrow, or today, depending on when you're listening to it. We'll call it today. I keep messing around with the dates. Yesterday, today, Thursday night, Titans at Ravens, -3.5, -110 on FanDuel. Obviously, if you can get the three on the Ravens, like it a little better. Get a little nervous laying the hook in preseason football, but I shouldn't really, because the Ravens, they've been on fire. John Harbaugh is an amazing 20-0 in his last 20 preseason games. And in those 20 games, the Ravens are 17-2-1 ATS, their last 20. Looking at the other side, again, coaching. I know I whiffed on the Hall of Fame game, but trust me, coaching is the way to go when handicapping the Hall of Fame game. Arthur Smith is 0-3 in last year's preseason slate, so I don't think they're going to be super amped up to get this done. And the Ravens just clearly are. I like the Ravens' depth as a team. I haven't talked about them win total wise, but you know, check out my individual team previews. Super high on the Ravens this year. I doubt Lamar's going to play. I'm pretty sure they already ruled him out, but they're pretty deep at quarterback. Also a little nugget here. The Ravens, of course, the number one team in special teams last year. You know, Harbaugh, former special teams head coach, they always have really good special teams. You throw in Justin Tucker and any special teams unit is going to look a lot better. But you think about it, and it's kind of obvious in hindsight, but special teams, there are no backups, right? Like, these guys are all backups. It's not you can't really rest your starters in preseason. And as much as maybe it would be a good idea to put out someone besides Justin Tucker to kick some field goals, you know, some sort of backup punter. I mean, heck, just like the concession stand guy, Justin Tucker just signed a big deal. The last thing you want is some crazy fluke non-contact injury for your kicker in a preseason game. That being said, they just don't have backup special teams players on the roster. So, you know, the team that's number one in special teams DVOA last year and consistently very good in special teams, I think there's a pretty strong correlation between the Ravens being good on special teams and them being really good in preseason. So, again, and obviously they take it seriously. They're 20-0, 17-2-1 against the spread. I'm going to be auto-playing them through the entire preseason, but the special teams nugget was something I kind of stumbled upon as I was diving deeper into preseason stuff. So Ravens, -3.5, -110 on FanDuel. Next up, we got a preseason total. That's right. If I'm playing a preseason total, it's almost always going to be an under. Giants at Patriots, under 33.5, -105 over on DK. Again, I think you want to get these as soon as you hear this, if you're going to be tailing it, because I do think, I do think, especially with the Ravens, there's going to be a ton of graphics coming out today. Like, oh, hey, they're so good against the spread. And the cat's going to be out of the bag. I'm surprised it's hung around this 4 -3.5. Maybe they're moving it based off Lamar, but Lamar normally doesn't play preseason. So, and same thing with the under. I wouldn't be surprised if this total goes down. So if you like the under, like I do, get in on it earlier. If you're just a maniac who wants to take the over in a preseason game, and maybe you're onto something. Giants at Patriots last year, that was their first preseason game that went over, but In this situation and historically, well, I mean, again, the over in preseason games since 2019, 41.2%. So that's a very strong trend. Both teams are installing new offenses. I mean, we all saw the Daniel Jones couldn't hit the out route debacle. So Daniel Jones playing, normally the starting quarterback playing would be a play to the over in preseason, but I think this is actually a play to the under. The guy that I'm honestly worried about as an Eagles fan and as someone taking this under is Tyrod Taylor. I think if Tyrod Taylor is going up against some of these twos and threes of the Patriots, maybe that's how they get the over. I still think 33.5 is pretty high. And you have Matt Patricia, Joe Judge. All the news coming out of Patriots camp is like they can't figure out the offense. The fact that Matt Patricia and Joe Judge, neither of them are offensive coordinators. Neither of them have called plays. I think this offense is really going to struggle with no Josh McDaniels. The Patriots haven't announced yet whether Mac Jones is going to play. I'd be surprised if he plays. So you're looking at a lot of Brian Hoyer and Bailey Zappi. So I think it's just going to be a super, super ugly game. And unders in games with totals below 35 or above 40. The under is 64.8% last couple seasons in preseason. So again, there can be outliers, but it's week one of the NFL preseason. Under is the way to go there. All right. Closing it out. We got, I got to go back to this. What am I not going to take the Phillies? Marlins at Phillies minus 159 on the money line over at Wynn. The Phillies, they've won 7 in a row. I'm just going to stay with this hot hand. There really is something to, you know, the Dodgers run line, Phillies money line, the Baltimore Orioles as a home dog. They are, I didn't see what the last Orioles number is, but them on the road where it's like not really, they're not getting that nice plus 1.5, minus 110 against the Red Sox. That just kind of scared me off them. So we're just going to keep it simple with the Phillies, minus 159 on the money line. Again, they're still 9-1 in their last 10. I think they're now 40-23 after a win. They're a very hot and cold team, and they've just been on fire. They had a brief little cold streak after the All-Star game, but other than that, and look out, National League, when Bryce Harper comes back, because this team is rolling. Kyle Gibson on the hill for the Phillies. He's 6-2, win-loss as a starter at home, and they're going up against the Marlins pitcher, Edward Cabrera, who is, his road numbers are decent, 3.07 ERA on the road, but he's only pitched 20 innings this season, so I don't think he has enough experience to handle these hot Philly bats. Don't let these Phillies get hot. Minus 159 on the money line over at Wynn. I'm also on the Giants at Patriots under 33.5, minus 105. Over on DraftKings, Titans at Ravens. I'm on the Ravens, minus 3.5, minus 110 on FanDuel. And hey, if you're betting preseason, again, Matt Friedman over bettingpros.com, click on his article. He laid out a bunch of good trends, angles, etc. Even some on Hard Knocks teams like the Lions. I'm sure we'll be talking about them tomorrow. So if you're getting down on preseason, a lot of fun nuggets in there as well. And as always, we're brought to you by BetMGM. Use the promo code JUICE150. Risk-free bet up to $1,000. That's right. Follow us on TikTok at BettingPros. Follow me on Twitter at Sean T. Green. Check out my other show, Sports Gambling Podcast, 32 NFL Team Previews. Win totals, futures for every national football team. Thank you, guys. As always, you know what to do. Subscribe, rate, review. And as always, don't forget to let it ride.